Hey there everybody, how's it going? It's L the Angry Nerd again today, and we're going to be playing some more Elden Friends Retro. So yeah, this time, pretty much what we're going to be playing is Final Fight. And what Final Fight is it was a side-scroller beat-em-up game that got changed into Streets of Rage. And Final Fight was the actual, like, original name of it, but then they changed it. And to me, either way, it's still awesome. Like, I love games like this that are just side-scroller beat-em-ups. And also, I love what they did for the Xbox version of this, because there's some really cool stuff. Like, for me, I'm gonna restart and start a new game. And I love how you scope into this, like, you're actually, like, playing the actual arcade, like, case thing. But yeah, and here, so we got Cody, we got Hagar, and then we got Guy. To me, my favorite was always Hagar, and I will always play Hagar. Excuse me, but the difference between this game is, you have challenges and stuff. And for me, it's like, I don't even mind, like, little challenges or other things, because, this is kind of like a remaster, more or less. Like, it doesn't sound like, you know, 16-bit or whatever, like, because, you know, we're playing it on Xbox, so it sounds different. Or, you know what I mean. Like, they still have the same sound effects, but they decided to, like, change up a couple things, so either way. Look at that German, that fucking German suplex. Everybody's getting suplexed. Yeah, and always the side-scroller games. Like, you got your A to jump, your B to punch, and then, you know, you figure out everything else while you go. Yeah, I loved Hagar. Hagar was still, like, he had to be my favorite. Oh, I forget how to do the specials on here. And also, too, if you had never played a side-scroller, your special meter actually did change things. Oh, the pipe! Oh, the classic Hagar pipe. Yeah, I always love games like this where it just go side to side and keep fighting dudes. That's always the coolest thing about these games. Then I love just going through South Town, just beating down people. Oh, there's a boss. Oh my god, it suplexed the boss. It's awesome. Oh, there we go again. Oh yeah, I forgot he calls out dudes. Shit. Yeah, I was like Hagar. Hagar was the best. I didn't like Cody or Guy. Like, Guy was just like the ninja dude, but I loved Hagar because he was honestly just his own star of the show. Oh yeah, there's poison. Or not poison, I mean. Also, yeah, obviously it's like you got like a limited continues and everything here. Oh, there we go. Oh, the double lariat, there we go. Look at that. Without losing mine lives. Honestly, that's not too hard. Okay, I lied about that. That might be a little hard. But can I even, like, punch the booth? Oh, I can punch the booth. I'm glad I got a katana, man. That's what I always loved about these games. They have so much of just their own type. Oh, there's fucking, Andre. or fucking Hugo, sorry. No, yeah, his actual name is Hugo. Or Andre, I think. I just remember him being called Hugo. Oh my god, that guy was just one shot. I forget, how can I throw weapons? There we go. Feels so weird not playing this on an actual cabinet, but at least you get the feeling of being in a cabinet. I always loved Hagger's persona as his character in general. Like, he's just, what do you call it? He's just, like, wrestler guy. And I always loved, like, his dad mustache. Oh my god, suplexing ladies is the best. It's awesome. I forget how to get health back on here. Like, I know it's just, like, look for shit. Oh my god, just give that guy suplexes all day. All day, it doesn't even matter. Don't even matter. Oh, you get one. I'm like Oprah, you get one, you get another one. Alright, go get a good old double lariat. Oh, fuck's sake, come on, man. Can I change? Oh yeah, I can change my thing too. Yeah, I just wanted to show some people. Like, I like Cody, too. I like also what he became. Because Cody was, like, he's not, like, a bad guy in this game, but in the other games, he was bad. Like, in the later games, like, Street Fighter. Oh my god, look at that dude. And everything else, like, he wasn't, like, a good dude. They turned him into a convict, pretty much, and Guy just stayed the fucking same. Also, I think another reason why I didn't care for Cody too much, like, he wasn't bad, it was just, like, he was too just generic dude for me. Like, I don't know, also, too, it's just, like, it's just something about Hagar. Like, Hagar made the game pop. Like, let me just pause that for a second. Like, wait, does that actually pause? No, it doesn't. Oh, okay. I want to see if it works like that, but it doesn't, so... But anyways, my thing was, shit. Alright, let's give Guy a thing. For me, it was just, like, Guy's ninja dude, so it's like, that's cool. Like, ninja guy's cool, like, I can't even lie and say they're not. But for me, it was just Hagar was just star of the show just because of who he was and what he was. And for me, always, it was like, I just picked Hagar when nobody else would want to pick Hagar. This game was just so awesome. Like, I loved everything they did with it, and I just love the whole style of just going through the street, beating up people. That's why they called it Streets of Rage. Or that's where Streets of Rage got birthed. Oh yeah, and that was another reason why I didn't really care too much for Guy and, Cody. Like, they kind of just felt like the same dude, to be honest with you. Except one was like, oh hey, I got, like, moral standards and I'm a ninja guy. Where Cody was just like, it's all about my girlfriend. Because that's the whole meaning of this story, is to actually, like, just find his girlfriend, pretty much. Okay. Oh, jeez. Okay. Oh yeah, now we're in a wrestling ring. Oh, we're fighting Saddam! I forgot! Oh my god, I forgot! Yeah, Saddam. What a job. God, Saddam is the best jobber. Oh god. And we're going back to Hagar, because I play through the cast. forgot he charges. And that's the lamest thing about Sidon. I forget how to beat him. It was the sword I was trying to get. I remember this, like, when I played this again. It took me a couple tries. Oh, that's like, tier 1 failed, and it's like, man, I forgot how to play this. Yeah, it's always nice. Oh yeah, I forgot Bones Stage. This is the thing they added in the Street Fighter, where it was like, beat up the car as best as you can. Yeah, wait, now we go to this side. Perfect! Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. I remember in, like, Street Fighter, like, whenever you do that, it, like, show the guy. Oh, there he is! There he is right there! He's like, oh my god! My He's god. Like, no! Look at my car! You bastards! Oh, I love that. That's the best. And I was like, man, I didn't know if it was in this. But yeah, I love that, like, going in for it. Like, and except on this, it's like, you're oh, baby, look at that. Like, he just goes in, and in Street Fighter, he just stares at him, like, pretty much. Like, after they do it, so it's like, Ryu, like, turns his back to the guy, and he's like, oh my god, look at my car! I love it. Oh man, that grab, though. The grab's nasty. I'll use the almighty jump kick. Oh, no, I'm dead. Oh my god, just a fist came out of nowhere. There we go. Oh no, I'm done. Oh, he butt slammed on me too. Oh, I killed him. Or I didn't kill him, I beat him down, I mean. Take those, because why not? Like, see, one thing I honestly wouldn't mind doing, like, thinking about this, I'd totally love to play through the Streets of Rage games. I'd totally love to do that. It'd be such a, like, fun thing to do. Oh, there he is. Oh my god, there's both of them. Oh yeah, I remember those dudes, the fucking Molotov guys. Like, they're super easy to kill. It's just, man, they're annoying because they mess up the ground so bad. So it's like, and obviously, think about it too, with these types of games, it's like, alright, let's throw some, like, annoying things just to get kids to put more quarters in. That was always the best thing about the arcades, too. Like, I love that. Like, I remember beating the Simpsons arcade game with, like, a couple of random dudes, and it was great. I love doing that. Like, it was so awesome, like, just playing through that. And, like, that last dude was so hard. Like, I remember, like, I think it was, like, my dad came in and was like, oh, man, like, we gotta go. And, like, do stuff. Yeah, no, this shit was awesome. Like, I just love that. Like, man, you just most of the time, it's like you wouldn't even like tell like what time it is after like just being in there. It's kind of like a portal, you know what I mean? Like in a good way, if you think about it. Big dick arm. Let me just lame it out. Just give him a couple under punches right there. Yeah, I think after we hit the next chapter, I'll probably swap to the next game that I want to play. Also, too, with these Ellen Friends retro things, if you guys honestly want to see me beat through all of them, just comment down below and be like, hey man, beat these games. Because, like, we've never played them, and we probably won't get them. Oh my god, look at that, I gave her, oh, that was like the Owen Hart power bomb. Oh, that would've killed that person. That would've killed Poison. Poison wouldn't be in Street Fighter because of that. Oh, that's great. Ooh, give me meat. There we go. I always love that, too. When you punch anything, a random hunk of meat comes out. It's like, who's the guy that's putting meat there? And I keep pressing start. So I was like, man, I thought I could pause it, but I gotta remember, man, arcades. You can't pause in arcades. There's no such thing as pausing in arcades. I'm fighting that one cop guy. Shit, I forget what his name is. I can't see it with there. But yeah, I love that dude. He just like shoot his gun at you. And like whip you with his billy club. Wow, that's like a one-shot kill pretty much. That's fun. And also too, no, I got the name of the game mixed up. Southtown is with Terry Bogard and some other people. I forget what town this is. Oh wait, no, this is Metro City. Yeah, this is Metro City. Fuck, I feel dumb. Sorry, I played like so many beat-em-ups, like legit, they all kind of like blended together. Like not in a good way, like, or not in a bad way, I mean in a good way. I just said that all fucked up. Yeah, I remember always hating fighting this dude because like all he'd do, we just lame it out from half screen. So yeah, you gotta give him the good old Yeah, this is what I loved about this game. Like, I loved it so much. And you know what? No, yeah, we'll continue with this. Because I want to get up to the part where I was before. Because I did play this a bit before, so I at least want to get to where I stopped myself. And also, sorry if I'm not playing as everybody, because, like, the biggest problem, too, it's like, for me, it's just like, with games like this, honestly, it's like, you find one guy, and it's like, man, that's the dude that I care about in this game. Like, the dude who just is awesome, and for me, it was always Hagger. Hagger was the best. I forgot how annoying this place is. Get out of here, Roxy, you reskin. Like, punching you off screen. Fuck you, Andre, get out of here. Or Hugo, because that's your new name now. Hugo. I don't even know why they changed his name, because his name is like Andre. Or his name is Andre on here, but they changed his name to Hugo. I think it might have been like, I don't know. There probably was some legal shit over that, or they might have just wanted to change it, I don't know. Yeah, I never really got that why they did that. Ain't even bad either, it was just kind of odd. I'm thinking about that, you know, I might actually look that up after this video. So So if I ever talk to people about this who are like-minded beat-em-up folks like I am, I totally wouldn't like that be like a good conversation thing. Shit. Nah, fuck me. Get my ass beat. Oh, there we go. Fuck you, fucking Andre, or Hugo, or whatever your name is. Oh, look, and I just fucking suplex Scorpion. Oh, that fucking butt slam, though. That butt slam hurts so bad. Ow, you know, I'll change Cody real quick. Why not? It don't really matter. Get more of the main cast in there. Yeah, also that was another thing I always liked too about these beat-em-up games. Like, the more times you use your special or whatever, like, you lose meter because of it, because you're using your special. Oh, I always love these missions. Oh, I love them so much. Where you're just sitting here and you're beating dudes up off the edge, pretty much. Like, I love that. It's always so cool. They would spawn him. I always thought it was the coolest grapple that Hugo had, or like, whatever, like, I'm just gonna call him Hugo. Yeah, the coolest grapple that Hugo had was where he just grabs your head and he starts fucking, like, squeezing it together. Oh my god, I love it. Oh my god, I punched her in the booty. I punched her in the booty while she was falling. I remember this is the one reason why I liked Cody, because, like, even though he was generic Joe McElike t-shirt man, I always loved that, like, Cody was, like, he had, like, some of the quickest punches out there. Oh, yeah, and then there is, Elgato. Who he, like, and the funny thing is, I love how, like, nowadays, when anybody thinks of Elgato, they think of Elgato Game Capture. Okay, let me just toss the shit at you, Dead Rising style. Ooh, grenades. Oh my god, look at that dude go. Finish the fight with Cody. Just Tagger comes in, sweeps. Oh, he blew himself up.
Oh man, look at that.
He blew himself up. Ready to go. Oh, I did it. Yo, look at that, I got a... Perfect. I love that same dude would just want to run in there and just be like, no, my glass. Oh, that would have been awesome. Yeah, you know, we'll do this mission, because I haven't done this mission. Like, and also too, in the arcade, it's like, it's so hard to, like, you know, beat all these games in, like, one sitting, because honestly, you can't, like... When you're young and you're in an arcade, honestly, it's like you're usually just there just to pass a little bit of time. Like, say we gotta do something, like pick up dry cleaning or do, like, whatever. And that's just how the arcades were, like, they were just like a tiny, like, time waster. So it's like, usually half the time when I remember beating some games, it's like I joined, like, in last second, and that's how I beat the game. Like, I've never actually, like, beat it, like, let's say, by myself type thing, and to me, it's like, I still don't feel right, because, like, you know, I'm still not using the quarter system, you know what I mean? But it's like, well, where would I put my quarters in, you know what I mean? We're gonna go back to Hagar. I miss suplexing people. Like, I don't mind judo throwing people out of people's backs, but man. Look at that doge ray there, look at him. Oh, there we go. Beautiful. Oh my god, look at all the fat dudes. Fat dude Brumble. Brumble. Oh no, I'm down. Shit. Sorry, I'm just focusing on a little bit. Oh, baby, look at that. That was awesome. I love that. I just fucking, like, Owen Hart powerbombed the shit out of that guy. And I love how, like, I love how much air he gets. Like, he just, like, holds him and then just knocks him straight down. Oh, I love it. Yeah, honestly, it's, like, legit, if you haven't been to an arcade, like, I suggest, like, hit up your local arcade, wherever you are. Because, honestly, like, they've probably got some pretty kick-ass games in there. Like, to be honest with you guys. Aw, no. I'm fighting Junior, and I'm fighting Senior. Aw, no. What is this? What is this? Oh good, they hit him too, that's awesome. Punch him right in the freaking groin. Also too, another thing to talk about. To me, I still think some shit's super silly with YouTube, like even though like I love this company. I love what, like, you know, that it's a media source where you can put, honestly, any to God thing on. That's what I like about YouTube. You can pretty much do what you want on here with your own thing. To me, I can understand, like, why a lot of people aren't a big fan of the whole monetization thing. If, say, you'd say fuck or whatever, like, your video might not be monetized or might not be shown up on the, what do you call it? On the platform more. And I know a lot of big channels are speaking out about it, because they're like, honestly, like, it feels like you're determining, like, for even, like, let's say, small channels like my own, like, not giving people, like, a chance to do that, but it's, like, I can kind of understand for the whole thing, because they're trying to run, like, a business. Not like just somebody's fun thing that they do. Like for me, it's like I think of this as just something fun to do. And if I'm able to actually make money out of this and do things out of this sooner or later, then I will turn it into somewhat of a business, because I totally love to. And it's like I remember making like not that much money, but like a bit from like one of my old videos or something like that. But, you know, it's like, let's say I get into, like, the millions, or, like, even the thousands, like, I'd try treating this more like a job than just a hobby, you know what I mean? It's kind of like saying, it's like, honestly, it's hard to really fucking motivate yourself when, like, legit, you, like, nothing's really showing for it. Like, I'm seeing the numbers pop, like, I'm seeing a lot of views, but I'm not really seeing a lot of sub growth or anything. And to me, it's like, it don't really matter, though, because honestly, I've been, like, recording, like, off and on for, like, not even, like, a year or two. Like, I think it'd be, like, getting 2 years, pretty much, like, since I've been recording. And to me, it, honestly, too, with the whole recording thing, it's just, like, I tried just, doing things my own way, and it's like, you know, going through university and everything was the main priority, because that's how it is, like, honestly. like, you know, go to university, do your shit, and then do the stuff that you want to do. That's just honestly how it is. I'm not saying it's like I don't want to go back, it's just, you know, I did everything I needed to do. Like, to get in there to be able to do what I want to do. Either way, like, to me, I feel university is just honestly a necessity. Or just something you should do. Because honestly, it opens up the door to better opportunities and blah, 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 whatever. You know what I mean? Or, unless if you're lucky, like, I don't want to say, like, names of famous YouTubers. You know what I mean? Because that'd be really scummy and whatever. But to me, I'm a no-nonsense guy. Honestly, that's a lot of things that people don't like about me. It's like, let's say these people that, like, let's say either got lucky or, you know, they built up the time and everything to do it. Like, you know, they, like, I don't want them, like, because back then, like, way, way, way back then in the day, like, it was easier just to do things during the Call of Duty 2, or, like, the Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2 era, like, there wasn't that many people making videos, like, it wasn't, like, that, like, you know, there wasn't a lot of people doing it. That's what I'm saying. So it's like nowadays it's kind of like hard to get the numbers that all these other like people have gotten. Okay, oh my god, I'm just getting stabbed and owned. But it's like, you know, people are still like, what do you call it? Like, they're still doing it. It's like I'm proud for the people that are doing it. But, you know, it's like, it's just kind of, like, it's hard to do it nowadays, because honestly, it's like, there's so many other channels out there now, just because it's like, everybody's been wanting to do this thing. A lot of people just do because it's fun, but a lot of people want to make a job and, like, a living out of it, and honestly, it's hard to think about it that way, because you kind of can. It's not really, like, you know, it's not really right off the bat, like, it's going to be, like, do we get, like, a million people, and that's just how it's going to be, like, it ain't like that. Hopefully I'm the challenge. Got gold bigger. That's awesome. I love all those little challenges, because like the cool thing, like I'll show, because this will probably just be like one episode. It'll be it'll just be Final Fight. Like it'll be still a retro thing, but it'll just be Final Fight. I honestly didn't expect this mission being that long. But I guess it is. Yeah, just honestly, like, a lot of people, how they think about it is, like, oh, they're just gonna become famous in, like, a fucking day or some shit like that, and honestly, don't work like that. And to me, it's like, I've been doing this for, like, 2 years, like, off and on, because, you know, all that. Oh, wait, oh my god, yeah, that's the guy from the cover. Well, he looks like Zubaz. Yeah, that's the guy from the cover of one of the Final Fight things. Oh, that's so cool. Except he's using Hugo's fighting stance. That's a bit silly. Oh my god. Yeah, this is hard. His name's Abigail. Oh, you know, he just taught me one. Ah, shit. Wow, he caught me from that, and then that's brutal. Oh, I forgot that's how this boss was beat. Yeah, you gotta wait till he charges you because he's kind of not invulnerable to damage, he doesn't take a lot. Like, when he gets charged, and that's when, ooh. That's when he, like, takes a bit more damage. Oh my god, look at that guy, that dude just spun out, like, right there just to get me. Oh yeah, we did it. Nice. But yeah, I guess that's pretty much it, because there's only, like, Uptown. Or maybe I can beat it. You know, yeah, we're gonna try to beat it. Why not? Ah, fuck it, this'll be me beating Final Fight. Why not? We're trying to, at least. But yeah, that's just pretty much my whole YouTube thing. And to me, it's like, I can understand, like, the get back to the YouTube thing, I can understand why people are kind of upset with how that is. But think about it, this is a portal where, you know, they honestly expect you to, you know, have a better type of, like, grasp on, you know, cursing and all that stuff, because they're trying to do, like, a business, not, like, a personal thing. You know what I mean? That's pretty much how it is. And I know a lot of people are speaking out about it, saying, like, oh, this is, like, bullshit, why is this even a thing? And, like, you know, I know Angry Joe and, like, you know, all these other people have been ranting about it. But it's like, come on, think about it, guys. Like, I know it's bullshit, but still, it's honestly, like, it makes sense. Like, you know, you wouldn't do that at your job. Like, you wouldn't, like, go to your boss and say, like, hey, fuck, shit, piss, like, whatever. Like, the whole nine yards, right? Because it just, that isn't how it is. So I can just, I can understand what YouTube's, like, doing, but it still is pretty dumb, because to me, I like cursing. Like, to me, I felt kind of the same with how other people did, that it was, like, whatever, like, you know, this is your channel, like, you should be able to run it however, like, the flying fuck that you want, to be honest, like, that's how I feel about it. And the good thing is, like, you can still do it, it's just, you know, don't get, like, hurt, or it's kind of like, don't get upset if you don't see your things getting monetized because of, like, this stuff, like, cursing or whatever. And who knows, I haven't honestly, like, checked on it and seen what's been happening with it, but I still think it's in effect, or something of that nature. But yeah, I don't know. I knew, like, a lot of people were upset about it, and people were speaking out, being like, hey, this is bullshit. Give me a minute, Final Fight. Alright, just wanted to take a drink. But yeah, I can't, like, to be honest, I can't even get upset about it. It's like, you know, it's a business. You wanna put your best face forward in a business, my aunt always says. Since my aunt's, like, part of, like, a really, like, crazy thing. But I don't know how I feel about it, too. It's, like, honestly, it's, like, if you do this for, like, just doing it on your spare time, if you get famous for doing it, then it's, like, right on, congrats. But, like, you know, is that, I don't know. Like, on one side of the plate, I feel, man, this is stupid. Like, this shouldn't even be, like, you know, this shouldn't be what it is. And also, I know another reason why people don't like doing it, because, like, let's say, you have to do more work putting, like, a PG rating on it, and, like, you know, stay off of PG things, and all that. Because I know, like, Coucha, they made a joke about it being like, hey, you know, stay off the age-restricted stuff, and then I remember in another thing they said, hey, they're, like, you know, we don't really even, like, age-restricted things, because honestly, we get less views for having age-restricted things. Because most of the people that honestly watch their things are young people, like, just watching YouTube. And that definitely cuts down on, like, the views and everything else. That's why I know I know why a lot of people are just doing things on Twitch. Because, you know, there's less, like, age-restricted things on Twitch. And also, too, it's just like, hey, get on here. What I'm gonna do is just turn on the thing and then just do what I gotta do. And it's like, man, if you're not on for the stream, you're not on for the stream. That's just how it is. Oh my god, look at that. I didn't think I'd do that. Whoops. Yeah, no, it's just, it's a little silly why people are getting, like, super upset about it, because honestly, too, it's like, man, if you can't stand not cursing that much, it's like, you know, you can always do what other people did, and what other people did was just go do that on Twitch. But still, I don't know, I haven't really checked up about it, because honestly, I'm a small channel. And to me, how I feel about that, because I remember a friend of mine was like, oh, did you hear about the whole, like, you know, you should start, like, not cursing more, and blah blah blah, and it's like, you fucking kidding me? Like, I'm not gonna just, you know, just quit being me because the company's gonna be like, hey man, like, quit being me, like, fuck that, don't do that shit. And honestly, people that, like, you know, have such fucking virgin ears, like, honestly, it's like, nobody's not heard fuck. Or shit, or piss, or ass, or, you know, the whole thing. Nobody's not heard of that. Oh, I skipped by those things. Nice. It's like, nobody's not heard those words before. Yeah, I've heard them, like, once or twice, so it's like, you know, whatever, like, it happens. Some people are just not great with keeping their profanity down. And for me, sometimes I can be one of them. When things get like a little bit frustrating or whatever, it's like you gotta say fuck. But yeah, for me it's just, I'm not too worried about it. Like, I'm just here making videos just because honestly they're fun, and like this is how it should be. Like, a lot of people get into the YouTube game thinking like, oh man, it's like, you know, you're just gonna fucking make like so much people just like that, you know, doing your GTAs or your Call of Duties, and honestly too, it's like that shit's even getting like overused, and like almost everybody does it, like, you know, just to get a quick view here or there, because what are little kids like? Like, sorry to shit on that demographic, but here, we're gonna fucking lay it down flat. What are little kids like? They like Terraria, they like Starbound, they like all this like kid things. Then it's like, what else do they like? They like GTA, and they like all these, like, things, like Call of Duty and everything else. And, like, it's not bad. Because, you know, they're kids, like, whatever. But still, it's like, that's honestly the demographic of a lot of them. And it's like, do you think kids have not heard shit or fuck before? Like, even, like, other YouTubers and stuff that, like, these people watch, like... Honestly, it's like, you know, no one's perfect, and to me that's how it honestly sounds. It's like, you know, you need to be picture perfect, you need to act like what you're not fucking supposed to be, and that shit's garbage, or act who you aren't, type thing. But to me, I'm a small channel, I don't gotta worry about that shit. Like, I know even some people honestly left corporations and other things because they just said, like, you know, or, and when I mean corporations, I mean, like, YouTubers. And I think everybody knows where I'm getting at with this. Like, if you've been caught up to date with that. Like, Dexter Manning, like, he was just, like, you know, I don't want to work for these people because, you know, for one, I thought they were my friends, and two, like, you know, just how they acted about the entire thing wasn't too great. Like the day when people tell me, hey, like, you shouldn't be uploading, that's the day that I fucking give up my channel. I swear to fucking Christ, that's how I feel about it. Like, the day where people tell me, hey, like, you know, you're, like, you should, like, think about, like, before you upload your things, no, fuck that. It's like, you fucking kidding me? It's like, this is my thing, it's like, you run your thing your way. And to me, it's always been kind of a thing that's crossed my mind, too, because I've had, like, family members and friends, like, you know, try talking like that with me, and it's like, honestly, it's like, like, if, like, how about I say that to your segment you do, you know what I mean? Like, I'd say, hey, you know, you're not doing this thing real good. Like, I'm up for, like, suggestions or whatever, but don't make me fucking second-guess my product. You know what I mean? I don't know. Like, that's always kind of a touchy thing, too. And you shouldn't, like, honestly, too, it's like, you should never think about, like, second-guessing yourself and doing that, like... Yeah, that's just how I feel about it. Like, unless if it doesn't meet your standards, then don't upload it. But if it doesn't meet somebody else's standards and they're saying to you that it doesn't, it's like, no, fuck you. It's my program. It's my thing. I do what I want. Within reason. But yeah. Damn, that's kind of a long thing. But sorry about that. Yeah, no, I really honestly just, like, that was something that I've been thinking about, like, for a long time. And also, too, like, since, you know, I'm gonna talk a little bit about this, like, actually my YouTube case is, or my YouTube has been actually brought up in the court of law because of bullshit reasons. You know, it's just like, you know, the last fucking day I hear, like, you know, or like the day I hear people telling me, like, hey, you know, you shouldn't be like doing this half or so or whatever, like, you know, that's the day I'm gonna hand over, like, my channel to you guys, password and everything. It's like, fuck that. And to be honest, that would never happen. I care about this fucking channel too much. And that's the main thing about it too. I'd never give up this. It's like my baby. And also too, like, honestly, like, to me it feels kind of like an archive about, like, how far I've gone with YouTube and everything. Boom. There we go. We did it. Oh, so that's her father. Oh, okay, cool. Look at that. I'm so glad to see you. They didn't hurt you. Whatever. I'm so sorry, Jessica. I thought I'd lost you like that. I lost your mother, and... Oh my god, look at that. I'm unlocking all that stuff. But yeah, that is Final Fight for you guys. I love you, Dad. And that's pretty much it. Look at that. Uploading to the leaderboards and everything. And I guess we'll just let this play for a bit, because honestly, I haven't seen this. Yeah, Final Fight. Top notch. Top notch quality. I love fucking Final Fight. I love Streets of Rage. I love all of it. Like, it's just, it's such a... Oh, it's such a good series. And I love that people don't forget about these guys, because, They bring them into Marvel vs. Capcom and, like, all these other good fighting games, like even Street Fighter, and yeah, it's just, oh, really good. Oh, shit. Just beat them down super hard, that's awesome. And there's that's pretty much it. Cody is like, I'm a straight just say no, because yeah, just auto-sum a project, or yeah, let me just do that. And there, that's pretty much it. I didn't mean to start that. Okay, but yeah, that's pretty much just Final Fight in a nutshell. If you, like I said, if you ever have the chance to play any of these games or do that, do it. Like, oh man, Final Fight, it's a great series. I love each Final Fight game. They're all good with their own thing. And honestly, it's just, you know, gotta go out and try it. So yeah, hope you guys enjoyed. Stay awesome, guys.